Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. Thank you for tuning in again. How have you been? I've been whelmed. Not over, not underwhelmed, just whelmed.
Hello, and thank you for tuning in to Mad Jane, your most watched and trusted source for the news of the day.
I got prescribed rest and energy distribution during the day, which is quite hard for me because I'm just like a steam train that just keeps on going, 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 going. But it's Christmas and I'm a huge fan of Christmas, so I couldn't let it pass without a Christmas special. But I had to adjust my plan. Before I was sitting at home, I had this huge idea that I would make a Victorian walking skirt, a Victorian shirtwaist, I would even make a Victorian blouse, and if I had time left, I would also do some trims for a hat and maybe even a Victorian corset. I realized that that was not going to happen. And that is okay, because you know what? If life gives you potatoes, you make potato salad.
And I got just the recipe. Hit it!
So instead of doing all these things, I rummaged around in my sewing room and I found a 50s corset that I've been working on in October. And it wasn't finished yet, and I thought, that's just perfect. Because it was something I could manage in this time frame and also in this state of me. So that is what we're going to do today. And this pattern is one of the big five. And there are a lot of things to unpack about this pattern. But before we go into that, shall we just see how it goes with the construction?
The pattern is quite simple. It only contains a few pattern pieces. Here you can see me trace it on my new tracing paper, which is a bit thicker than what I normally use. So technically, I could make this corset again, if I wanted to. Which I probably don't. And here you see me cutting the pieces. It's really quite simple and just like my other videos. For this project, I use coutil, which you can see here. It's from La Rose Passementerie and it's beautiful. This is the four-way stretch mesh that I used, and it's super slippery and works very much, so it goes every way. Even my sewing machine had some trouble with the mesh, but it was a nice and a new challenge to work with this type of fabric. Here you can see me preparing the cutouts by making an edge where I can clip and iron the raw sides to the inside. Here you can see me attach it to the sides. It's really important for the shape that I get this right. And this is how it's supposed to look. And then it's just attaching. And this is the finished product. I didn't think I would love it this much, but it really is an eye-catching detail of this corset. Here I'm using a non-conventional method, namely I'm using a bra boning. A boning channel instead of a normal boning channel, but it was the only thing I had at hand and it did fit with my steel boning that I had in mind. Here you can see me preparing the lining of the corset, and this is the lining of the main part of the corset. It's supposed to kind of close like a book upon itself, so that you can make boning channels in this part. Here I'm making the boning channels from the coutil. And now I need to go on to the seal boning. I got out my heavy machinery and clipped all the pieces as long as they should be and filled the corset. And then I put on the picot etching. And here you can see me making the tracing for the holes, which had a lot of trouble because my hands are just way too weak, so I couldn't get them in properly.
I swear by every god and every demon that I will crush your skull.
And this this is what I ended up with. So I asked my dad for help, and then Thomas, my partner, said, but why didn't you let me do it?
Are you challenging my manliness?
Yes.
But anyways, the eyelets turned out fine, thanks to my dad. And then it was time for the finishing touches, where I put some lingerie bows onto this corset, and then it was just time to put on the lacing. And here you can see the finished product. I am super in love with this. It really helps with the figure. It's not as dramatic as I had hoped it to be, but I'm pleased with it. I could use some more negative ease, but hey, it is what it is.
And so with this corset done, I can start to unpack things about this pattern. In the end, it was quite easy to follow. It was quite clear. However, which is also something I found on the internet, so it's not only me that was struggling a bit with that, is that the front cover image is different from the diagram on the back. And this also happens in the whole instructions thing, that they change up how the boning is supposed to look in the front. So on the model, she's wearing the boning like this. And on the diagram, they suddenly point downwards, which is a strange shape for a corset. So that was a bit of a struggle in the beginning, but luckily I found reviews of this pattern which stated the same. So I just kind of went with what I felt was the right way of the boning, which was this way. Also, I felt like the boning was a bit short for the length of the corset, or the width if you will. So those were really my only complaints. And for this project, I, for the first time ever, used stretchy materials like elastics and also the stretchy mesh. I must say, I do never ever want to work with stretchy mesh again because it works so much. It's such a struggle. But it was so cool to have worked with it, and I think the result is quite cool. So in the end, I am super pleased with how this all turned out.
I also tried on this corset with my Collective clothing because both the top and the trousers are from Collective and they never sat quite right. But now with this corset, I really feel like it just fits. Which also means that Collective really looks like the figure from the time which was it meant to represent.
And in the spirit of Christmas and sharing, here's a little piece of more information about me, is that I am half Danish. And today I wanted to share with you one of my favorite traditions during Christmas time, which is folding Christmas stars. In Denmark, this is something that's done quite often, and I've been doing it since I was a little child with my nieces, my nephews, but also with my grandmother and also my mother. And it's a really fun thing to just do on a lazy Sunday or a lazy afternoon during the Christmas holidays. And I really wanted to share this with you. And there are tens of millions of other things that I can go into, but this is not that type of video. But I wanted to share the Christmas star tradition with you today. And if you do not have pre-made strips, which is possible because I bought my strips at Zuster & Grene, which is a Danish shop that's also situated in the Netherlands, but also in Denmark. But if you do not have these strips, you can still make these stars. I'll show the dimensions. And then you can just clip 4 strings of this piece of paper, so you can just enjoy this tradition as well. And without further ado, let's get started.
As you can see, I had prepared 4 strips of the same color, but I came back to this and decided to use 2 different colors so you can see where I'm going with every step. Make sure to fold them in half properly. This makes the end result much neater. And now we have 4 strips to start with. First you take one strip and then you kind of hook the second one on it. Make sure to catch it in between. This way you'll try to make a little square. So your third strip will do the same. And then the fourth strip, you will catch the red strip and then take the pieces of the white strip and put it inside the other red strip. And this way you kind of have made a braided square. After you've done this, you'll try to pull the sides a bit, so it's secure, but not too secure. Take all the strips, and starting with the first one, you will fold them to the inside. You do this to the second, third, and fourth as well. The fourth one is a little bit different though, because you will let this pass over the first white strip you encounter, and then you will braid it under the second strip you will find. This way, your square is nice and secure. And now we will start to make the points. You do a backwards flip with the strip. And then you make the weirdest loop as possible, just like I do. And then braid it and then pull. Be gentle, because if you do this too hard, the paper will rip. You can jiggle it around a little bit to make it more pointy. I wasn't that lucky this time, but sometimes you can get them quite nice and pointy. You will repeat this 4 times on each side. So just turn counterclockwise and start again. Well, quite easy, right? You can see me fiddle a little bit with the points. I'm a little bit of a perfectionist here. And now you just do this for all the 4 sides. Now you will flip your star over. And just do the same, but on the other side. So, you make a backward fold, make a loop, and make a point. And this is what it's supposed to look like now. Now you will bend all the strips backwards. Secure them by giving them a little push so they stay in place. It's time to make the points on the top. To do this, you'll take the white strip and then you'll bend it forward. Make it nice and crisp and then fold it out of the way. You'll take the strip and wiggle it in between the other strips like I do here. If you do it right, you should see it appear in between the layers, and you can just gently pull. Don't pull too hard, as the point will go apart, and if it does, you can always give the little squeeze to make it go back in place. You'll see this in the next point. So again, you take the strip, do a forward bend, get it out of the way, loop, and slide in between. Jiggle if you can't get it through right. And here you can see that I pulled too hard, so I squish it, and now it's a fine point again. And just rinse and repeat with every part. And now you'll have 4 points. You'll turn your star, and do exactly the same, but don't forget to put all the strip backwards first. If you have a trouble with getting the strip through, you can try to jiggle it, because you can see it's kind of folding onto itself, but if you kind of hold it closer and can jiggle it a little bit, it will go through eventually. And now for the last point. I will show you a little bit of troubleshooting. I didn't get this through properly, and that happens sometimes, particularly with the last strip. So what do you do? You take a pair of scissors and you just snip off a little corner. This makes it a bit easier to slide through. You can see I wasn't quite ready to give up yet, but I had to. So snip it off, and then the sliding through goes much easier. There it goes. You can see it appear on the other side and then pull gently. And now you have to cut off the remaining strips. Be careful not to cut into your points or the other pieces of paper. You can actually use smaller scissors for this, but I was lazy and didn't get them out. You can also kind of push the strip a bit upwards, like you can see me do here. So you have a little bit of room. And then when you're done, you kind of squish the white piece of paper in place so you don't see it in your red points. And ta-da, you're done! And if you want to put it in your Christmas tree, just take a needle, put it through your paper, and do a little thread in between. And then you're done.
And just like that, we've reached the end of another video. Thank you so much for watching. It really means the world to me. I really hope that you'll have lovely holidays. So, fijne kerstdagen, Merry Christmas, Goljoen, and may 2021 stay far behind us. And to 2021, goodbye, good luck, good riddance. And may everyone have a really great new year. 2022, we're ready for you. Let's make it a better year than last year.
In Junkered ved juletid,
jing jang jing lucidai.
Omkring ham dalede sneen hvid,
jing jang jing lucidai.
Han stræd sig frem i regn og blæst med et, der sejnede hans hest.
Jing jang lu, jing jang lu, jing jang jing lucidai.
And I forgot to actually do a proper outro. So please like, favorite, and subscribe, and recommend this video to all your friends. I really hope you enjoy making the Christmas stars, and show me a picture if you've done it. That would make me so stoked. So for now, I'll see you guys in the new year. Bye bye!